Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Hopkinton High School for Hopkinton Hillers Baseball. It is Thursday, May 19th, and today the Hopkinton Hillers will welcome in the Millis Mohawks. Hopkinton is 8-7 on the season, while Millis is 2-14. Hillers still 2 wins away from getting a playoff spot, hoping to get one step closer here this afternoon. Bob Hamilton on camera, Tom Nappy on the call. Getting the start today for the Hopkinton Hillers is Jeff Holler, and he actually pitched a little bit yesterday in a 9-inning loss to Bellingham. Came in and threw 11 pitches in relief, but should be set to go today with a good amount of rest. Let's take a look at the Hopkinton Hillers field. Jeff Holler on the mound, Alex Reynolds behind the plate, Ryan Wolf over at first base, Kyle Halloran is going to be at second, Jake LeBlanc over at third base for the Hillers. Jack Vaccari is the shortstop. From left to right, Sam Lehman, Connor Hebert, and Drew Simme round out the Hopkinton Hillers field. And now for the Millis Mohawks batting order, leading off the shortstop, Andrew Brooks, batting second to third baseman Ryan Smith. Max Moore and the designated hitter will hit third. Billy Barrett, the first baseman, will hit in the cleanup role. John Manning, the catcher, will bat fifth. Hitting sixth, the second baseman, Bryce Latosik. Batting seventh is the left fielder, Jared Pittman. Batting eighth, the right fielder, Tim Horahan. And rounding out the Millis batting order is the center fielder, Chris Edwards. Well, the Hopkinton Hillers have played pretty well this season, certainly a step up from last year, and they've been hitting well as of late, and they've won some pretty good pitching matchups, and they put themselves in a good position to clinch a postseason spot. You need to get to that 10-win mark, and today they hope it to make win number 9 as we are set to go here on a cloudy, chilly day at Hopkinton High School. Temperatures at about 69 degrees as Jeff Holler is set to throw the first pitch of the game. Holler gets the sign and deals. And there's strike one to the lefty, Andrew Brooks. Millis, a pretty young team this year. Lineup and the pitch, that one down low. On the Millis roster, there's only 4 seniors, so a pretty young team for the Millis Mohawks. Wide up and the pitch, that's fouled away, 1-2. Jeff Holler certainly throwing gas out there to start things off. Holler is set to deal. That one upstairs, 2-2. Jeff Holler has had a pretty good season on the mound. We'll get you the stats in just a moment. And this is hit in the air to right field, and the second baseman, Hebert, ranges over to make the catch, or excuse me, Halloran. And there's out number one. And that will bring up Ryan Smith, the third baseman for the Millis Mohawks, as he steps in. Wind up and the pitch. And this is a high fly ball towards center field, and now starting to fall a little faster, and it's handled by Jack Vaccari, the shortstop, who has time to range over and make the catch. And now Max Morin, the designated hitter, will come up to the plate. Jeff Holler is 1-4 in 5 appearances, started 4 games, a 3.32 ERA. But he's pitched pretty well this season. Just hasn't had the best luck with run support. As this is on the ground, left side, glove by the third baseman, throw to first, not a problem. And Millis goes down in the top of the first. 1-2-3 as we head to the bottom of the first. It's a scoreless game between Millis and Hopkinton. Welcome back to Hopkinton High School. We are set for the bottom of the first inning. A scoreless game as the Hillers will come up to the plate for the first time here today. Let's take a look at the batting order for the Hopkinton Hillers. Leading things off is the second baseman, Kyle Halloran, batting second, the shortstop, Jack Vicari. Alex Reynolds, the catcher, batting third. Drew Simi in the cleanup role, playing right field. Jake LeBlanc, the third baseman, will bat fifth. Sam Lehman, the left fielder, will bat sixth. Jeff Haller, the pitcher, will bat seventh. Connor Hebert, the center fielder, batting eighth. Ryan Wolf, the first baseman, hitting ninth as the first pitch down low. For the Millis Mohawks, the pitcher is Pat McAvoy. As McAvoy is set to deal, the junior. There's strike one. Let's take a look at the Millis Diamond. Behind the home plate is John Manning. Billy Barrett over at first base. Bryce Latosik at second, Brooks at shortstop. Is that pitch down low? It's Andrew Brooks. Ryan Smith at third base. From left to right, Jared Pittman, Chris Edwards, and Tim Horahan. The 2-1 pitch, swinging strike. It's 2-2 on Halloran. And we'll be on the weather watch for this game. Chances of thunderstorms possible later this afternoon. As there's strike three, gets Halloran looking. That'll bring up Jack Vicari. Jack Vicari having a great season with the bat, a .491 batting average, has played in all 15 games. Overall 27 for 55 at the plate, 19 runs scored. Three homers on the season as that pitch down low. And two of those three came in a game that we had for you on HCAM, which was against Medfield, a 20-2 victory for the Hillers in that game. On the ground, left side, gloved by the shortstop. Throw to first is going to be in time. So Vicari goes down 6-3. Two away for the catcher, Alex Reynolds. As the righty will step in. Alex Reynolds having a great season at the plate as well. A .426 batting average for the junior. 10 runs scored. 15 driven in. McAvoy delivers. That one's in there for a strike. And this should be a pretty good pitching matchup today. Pat McAvoy, one of the better pitchers for Millis. And this is hit into center field. That'll drop down for a base hit. And Alex Reynolds keeps his offensive streak going as he is aboard with a single. A two-out single, and that'll bring up the cleanup hitter, Drew Simi. Simi, the right fielder today. He's played in all 15 games as well, hitting at a .298 mark as McAvoy works from the stretch. That one down low. Simi has scored 8 runs, driven in 9. Has 7 doubles on the season as McAvoy delivers. That one's fouled away, got a piece of his leg there. And that's 7 doubles for Simi, leads the team. McAvoy working from the stretch, Reynolds at first. The 1-1 pitch, the check-in at first, runner slides back safe. Runner leading off of first, McAvoy set to deal. That one just upstairs, 2-1. Millis, led by head coach Mike Carter, while the Hopkinton Hillers, led by head coach Jay Golden, wind up and the pitch. And that is hit into left field. That'll drop in for a base hit, and then get by the reach of Jared Pittman, the left fielder. Reynolds is going to keep going to third, being waved around. He's going to try to score, and he will score. It's going to be 1-0 Hillers. An RBI double for Drew Simme. And the Hillers on the board. That'll bring up Jake LeBlanc, the third baseman. That ball just kind of got away from Pittman over in left field. That allowed many extra bases. As LeBlanc steps in. Wide up in the pitch, that's fouled away down the left side. McAvoy set the deal. On the ground, up the middle, it is bobbled by the shortstop and everyone's safe. So LeBlanc reaches on the error. Simme pushes up to third. So now runners on the corners with two outs. And that'll bring up Sam Lehman, the left fielder. The Hillers have just done this so much this season. Sam Lehman has played in 12 games. A .333 batting average, has been hitting the ball well as of late. That pitch down low. Lehman has scored 5 runs, driven in 3. McAvoy from the stretch, runner leading off of first, check in, runner back safe. Lehman steps back in. McAvoy set the deal, runner leading off of first. That one just outside, 2-0. Wide up and the pitch. That's fouled away. 2-1. One run already in for the Hillers. An RBI double by Drew Simme, scored Alex Reynolds here in the bottom of the first. Runner off the bag. McAvoy set the deal. Just low. 3-1. McAvoy from the stretch. And this is hit in the air towards center field, and ranging over is the center fielder to make the catch. And that will be the third and final out of the inning, but not before the Hopkinton Hillers play to run. It's 1-0 heading to the top of the second. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Golden Pond Assisted Living. Golden Pond, state-of-the-art senior housing and healthcare services. You can find them online at goldenpondassistedliving.com. Hillers leading 1-0, top of the second, as Billy Barrett steps in. Jeff Haller set to deal. There's strike one. 0-1, and some light rain starting to fall here at Hopkinton High School as Haller with the leg lift and the pitch down low. 1-1. The forecast was certainly a little bit unpredictable today. At one point, it looked like the rain was going to come at 4:35 o'clock as there's a strike. And now it's starting to fall early on, but then they pushed back the rain until 6 or 7. So the forecast has been very unpredictable throughout the state today. Some teams already canceled their games as that is fouled into the catcher's mitt for strike three. One away, that'll bring up John Manning, the catcher. Holler is set to deal to the righty. That's fouled away. 0-1. Of course, if there is any thunder and lightning, which is a possibility today, this game will come to a halt. Holler set to deliver upstairs. Wind up and the pitch. Just outside, 2-1. Holler deals down low, 3-1. Wind up and the pitch. And this is on the ground, takes a couple hops on the infield. Grass picked up by the shortstop. Throw to first in time. 6-3 goes Manning, and now Bryce Latosik, the second baseman, will come up to the plate. Rain's starting to fall a little bit harder. Wind up and the pitch. There's a strike. He deals. A couple hops on the infield grass once again. Picked up and bobbled by the shortstop. Could not get the throw off, and Latosik reaches. That was a tough one to play for Vaccari. That took an awkward bounce. It's arguable if you'd rule out a single or an error. And it appears the rain going to come a little earlier than anticipated today as it starts to fall a little bit harder as there's strike one to Jared Pittman. Holler set the deal. And this is hit in a right field, and that'll drop down for a base hit. So two on with two outs. That was a pretty good piece of hitting there by Pittman. Knew exactly where he wanted to drive it and just kind of chipped it into right field as Tim Horahan will come up to the plate. Wind up and the pitch. And this is hit into right field. That's going to drop down for a hit. Runner staying put. It'll be bases loaded for Millis with two outs. So three straight singles. That'll bring up Chris Edwards, the center fielder. Holler set to deal. There's strike one. Wind up and the pitch. Strike two. Holler shakes off the sign and now deals. And this is once again up the middle, picked up by the second baseman. Throw to first, not a problem. And 4-3 goes Edwards, and that'll retire the side. On the top of the second, three hits for Millis, but no runs. We head to the bottom of the second, the Hillers leading 1-0. Bottom of the second inning, due up for the Hillers. The 7, 8, and 9 hitters, a 1-0 lead for Hopkinton. As Pat McAvoy set to deal. There's a swinging strike to Jeff Holler. Pitcher versus pitcher here. Millis had three hits in the top of the second, but no runs. That one down low. All three hits came with two outs. The 1-1 pitch to Holler. And this is going to take a couple hops on the infield grass before rolling to the shortstop. Throw to first, not a problem. Good throw across the diamond by Andrew Brooks. One away. That'll bring up Connor Hebert. As Hebert steps in, McAvoy deals. That one just inside, 1-0. Lined up and the pitch, down low, 2-0. The leg lift and the pitch. There's a strike. Two and one. And this is down the first baseline. Fair territory, rolls on the infield grass, and McAvoy picks it up and handles it himself. So there's a rare one unassisted ground out for the second out of the inning. And it'll bring up Ryan Wolf, the second baseman. The lineup and the pitch to Wolf. That one just low, 1-0. Leg lift and the pitch. There's another low one, 2-0. Ryan Wolf, a junior, playing in his 11th game, but has only had 6 at-bats. Typically just a defensive player. There's a strike, 2-1. Line up and the pitch. And he makes contact, hops on the infield grass over to the shortstop, throw to first, not a problem. And 1-2-3 they go in the bottom of the second. Heading to the third with the score, Millis nothing, Hopkinton 1. Welcome back to Hopkinton High School as Millis will bat here on the top of the third. The 1, 2, and 3 hitters do up. Andrew Brooks, Ryan Smith, and Max Morin. As the shortstop set to step in and face Jeff Holler. Rain has come to a halt, at least for now. Just a quick little drizzle that passed by. Thunderstorms expected later, as that one is tipped foul. 0-1. Holler with the leg lift and the pitch. That one down low, 1-1. Holler deals, and this is hit in the air at a play foul. Brooks lined out and is only at bat in this game in the first inning. Holler delivers. Swinging strike gets away, and Brooks is going to beat this out. So Brooks reaches safe after the strikeout. That'll bring up Ryan Smith. That was a rough break there. Just kind of took an awkward bounce in front of Reynolds. Holler deals, down low, 1-0. Holler delivers, runner taking off from first. The throw over to second is just a little bit too far to the right side. Fell out of the glove of Halloran, and safe with the stolen base is Andrew Brooks. Pretty good throw to up the gut, though. A 1-1 count as Smith steps back in. And this is hit in the air in foul territory and out of play. One and two. Holler awaits the sign. Runner leading off of second base. There's strike three, a swinging strike. And technically, that's the second strikeout in the inning for Holler. But the first hitter of the inning, Andrew Brooks, reached on a pass ball. Now Max Morin, the designated hitter, steps in. Holler deals down low. Runner leading off of second. Holler delivers, turns away the hitter. There's a ball. Holler certainly not afraid to paint the inside corners. And is pretty good at it. Line up in the pitch is hit into center field. That'll drop down. Runner being waved around third. The throw home, not in time, and the game is tied at one. An RBI single for Max Morin. I'll bring up Billy Barrett, the first baseman. Holler from the stretch, runner leading off of first. Wide up and the pitch. Upstairs. 1-0. Swinging strike. 1-1. Holler set to deal. Fouled into the backstop, 1-2. Well, a pass ball. After the strikeout to Andrew Brooks, really costing the Hillers here in this inning, now a tie game. And there's strike three to Billy Barrett. That'll bring up John Manning. That one just a little bit low, 1-0. That one low, 2-0. Holler set to deal. There's a strike, 2-1. And this is going to take a couple hops on the infield. Grass glove by the third baseman. Good throw to second. And they will get the force out for the third out of the inning. The game is tied at one as we head to the bottom of the third. Bottom of the third inning, the Hopkinton Hillers coming up. A tie game, one apiece, as stepping in is Kyle Halloran. The rain starting to fall again. Wind up and the pitch. And this is on the ground, third base side, and it'll get by the reach of Ryan Smith. Looked like it went right through his legs. And Halloran will stop at first, a leadoff single, Jack Vicari to the plate. That'll bring up Vicari, who grounded out his last time up in this game. Now the way this would work if, and right now there's a timeout, catcher getting his batting gloves. Now the way that this would work if the rain gets severe to have an official game, it has to go at least 4.5 innings. Because right now there's a pause in the action for the Millis Mohawks. We have a new player coming into the game. Jake McKee is coming in to play third base. So Jake McKee comes in for Ryan Smith. And I wonder if Ryan Smith got hurt on that ball that was hit his direction. Hopefully he's okay. Jack Vicari will step back in. And we are set to go. Runner leading off of first, check in, runner back just safe. And no, they're gonna call him picked off. So Halloran picked off first. Good check move by McAvoy, one away. That is rough. Wind up and the pitch. There's a ball. 1-0. To the set. Up the middle. Glove by the shortstop. Throw to first in time. Vicari goes down 6-3. That'll bring up Reynolds. Alex Reynolds had a single and scored the only Hillers run of the game in the first inning. He scored after an RBI double by Drew Simme. This is a part of the order that the rally got started in the first. So perhaps we'll have a repeat. And getting back to the rain rules, obviously the game cannot end on a tie. As there's a strike, so what would happen if the rain got bad, they would pick up on another day right where they left off here today. Wind up and the pitch, down low. Swinging strike. 2-2. Leg lift and the pitch. Up the middle, and it's dropped by the shortstop. And Reynolds will reach on the error. Second error of the game for Millis, and that'll bring up Drew Simme. Well, any run that scores from here on out in this inning for the Hillers would be unearned. Checking at first, runner nearly picked off. Great pickoff move McAvoy has. McAvoy from the stretch. Wind up and the pitch. And this is hit in the air to left field and foul. 0-1. Simme got a good piece of that one. as he steps back in. Runner leading off of first, wind up and the pitch. There's a strike. From the stretch. And this is hit in the air to left field and ranging back and making the catch is the left fielder Jared Pittman for the third and final out of the inning. We will head to the top of the fourth. The game is tied at one. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by WPC Pest Control. Don't tolerate your pest problem, eliminate your pest problem. You can find them online at WPCPest.com. Top half of the fourth inning, a 1-1 ball game here on a cloudy, rainy afternoon. As Holler getting set to work once again. Due up for Millis is the 6-7 and 8 hitters. Bryce Latosik, the second baseman, will start things off here in the fourth inning. As this is up the middle, a couple hops on the infield. Grass picked up over by second base, throw to first, not a problem. Nice throw by Vaccari, one away. 6-3 ground out there. That'll bring up Jared Pittman, the left fielder. Wind up in the pitch, down low. 1-0. Set to deal. And this is going to be fair down the third base line. And that is going to be a base hit. And I don't know if the hitter was aware of it. He stays over at first. And that was just fair. That took an awkward, awkward bounce. So that is a single for Pittman. That'll bring up Tim Horahan. One out, one on. Wind up and the pitch. It's down low. Good block by the catcher. Runner leading off of first. Fouled away. That was off of Reynolds, the catcher. Certainly a good thing catchers wear chest protectors. Holler looks over at first as the runner taking a bit of a lead. And this is up the first base line, glove by the first baseman. Good throw to second, throw back to first, and it is going to get away, but they do get one of the outs. So Horahan reaches on the 3-6 fielder's choice, and there's two away. It'll bring up Chris Edwards. Swinging strike, 0-1. Holler set to deal. Swinging strike, 0-2. Holler to the set. That one just upstairs. 1-2. There's strike three. That'll do it for the top half of the fourth. To the bottom of the fourth we go. The game is knotted at one. Jake LeBlanc, Sam Lehman, Jeff Holler due up for the Hopkinton Hillers, the 5, 6, and 7 hitters Bottom of the fourth, tied at one. And the weather forecast getting interesting. The radar not looking promising, showing some rain moving in as that pitch down low. 1-0. As LeBlanc, the third baseman, steps back in. The lineup and the pitch. And this is hit in the air to right center, and that is going to drop in front of the dive of the center fielder, Chris Edwards. And now rounding first over to second with the double is Jake LeBlanc. And a runner in scoring position for the Hillers. And that will bring up Sam Lehman. Lehman flew out his last time up. Runner leading off of second. Lineup and the pitch. Up the middle, and bobbled once again by the shortstop. And everybody's safe. LeBlanc stayed put at second base. Lehman reaches on the third error by the shortstop of the game, and that is going to bring up Jeff Haller. Rain starting to pick up significantly. Two on. The bunt up the first baseline. That is in fair territory. It'll be picked up by the first baseman, but both runners will advance. So Haller, you can credit him with the sacrifice ground out. LeBlanc up to third, Lehman up to second, Connor Hebert to the plate. And this game not far from being called, as the catcher will go out and talk to the pitcher. And starting to rain heavily here in Hopkinton. If the Hillers get a run, that could put this game in a, actually they'd have to play at least 4.5 for the game to end early, so they would have to squeeze in the top of the fifth. Or else the action would just be suspended. So that one's fouled away. McAvoy set to deal. That one just low. Leg lift and the pitch. This is hit in the air, a high fly ball to center field, ranging over and making the catch. With no problem, but the runner will tag from third and score, and the Hillers back on top. And now another run going to try to score on the overthrow, both runners safe. So LeBlanc comes around, and then Lehman comes around on the errant throw, and it's 3-1 Hillers. So how about that? A 2 RBI sacrifice flyout for Hebert. And that'll bring up Ryan Wolf. And now the Millis pitcher will have a discussion with, the Millis coach will have a discussion with his pitcher, McAvoy. Mike Carter out there to talk to Pat McAvoy. 3-1 Hillers here in the fourth. As set to step in is Ryan Wolf. Wind up and the pitch. That one just low, 1-0. Couple of rough breaks for Millis. McAvoy's having a pretty good pitching performance up there, but a couple errors have kept the innings alive and allowed the Hillers to rally a bit. There's a strike. 1-1. Line up and the pitch. Just low. 2-1. Set to deal. And this is hit in the air to right field, and it is going to drop in fair territory. Rounding first on his way to second with a double is Ryan Wolf. And that'll bring up Kyle Halloran. A two-out double by Wolf. Miller's trying to add a few more runs here. Runner leading off of second. Wide up in the pitch, and this is fouled away left side, but he crushed that one. Halloran steps back in. Wide up in the pitch. And this is crushed into center field, but the center fielder playing deep, and he will make the catch. Nice catch by Chris Edwards, and that'll put a close to the bottom of the fourth, but not before the Hopkinton Hillers plate two more runs. It's 3-1, heading in to the top of the fifth. Top of the fifth inning, Millis coming back up to the plate, trailing by two. Top of the order due up as Andrew Brooks will start things off. Jeff Holler back out there, and the rain has been on and off throughout the afternoon, has gotten a little bit heavier over the last inning or so. Leg lift and the pitch, down low, 1-0. Holler deals. And this is hit in the air to left center, and that is going to be dropped by Reynolds, and then he slips on the center field grass, a leadoff single. That'll bring up Jack McKee, the third baseman. He came into the game earlier. Holler set to deal. Upstairs. One and oh. And this is hit in the air to right field, and it'll be caught in the right place at the right time is Drew Simme. One away. Brooks stays put at first base. Max Morin to the plate. Runner leading off of first. There's a strike checking at first. Runner slides back safe. The 0-1 pitch is a ball. Runner taking off from first, and the throw will get into center field. So a stolen base for Brooks. That's his second stolen base of the game. Holler set to deal. Just inside, 2-1. And this is hit foul, 2-2. set to deliver. Down to third baseline, that's foul. Two and two. Time called. Rain expected to pick up again in a little while as it has died off for now. Holler from the stretch deals. Down low, and it'll get by Reynolds, and the runner will advance to third. So Brooks up to third on the wild pitch. And with one out, you have a 3-2 count with a runner on third for Millis. As Max Morin awaits the pitch. And this is a high fly ball towards shallow center field. And the catch will be made. Runner tagging from third, and now we'll go back to third. Two away. Good throw in by Connor Hebert. Billy Barrett, the first baseman, up to the plate. Line up in the pitch, and therefore a strike. Oh, and one. Holler deals upstairs. Set to deliver. There's a strike, one and two. Wind up and the pitch, upstairs. Two and two. Fouled away. Count remains two and two. Two outs, two balls, two strikes, and a runner on third. Down low, full count. Wind up and the pitch, swinging strike. And that will do it for the top half of the fifth inning. The Hopkinton Hillers lead the Millis Mohawks 3-1 as we head to the bottom of the fifth. Bottom of the fifth inning, Hillers leading Millis 3-1. Jack Vicari stepping into the batter's box. Two up this inning for the Hillers. 2-3 and four. Jack Vicari, Alex Reynolds, Drew Simme. As McAvoy set to deal. Down low, 1-0. McAvoy delivers. That's down low, 2-0. McAvoy deals, Swinging strike, 2-1. As this is up the middle, and that'll get by the shortstop. A leadoff single for Vaccari. I'll bring up Alex Reynolds. One on, no outs to start off the bottom of the fifth. Wide up and the pitch. Vaccari taking off. The throw up the gut is going to be dropped by the shortstop, or the second baseman, excuse me. So stolen base for Vaccari. The pitch was a ball. And a rainbow starting to form towards left field as we get time. Rain has stopped for now, at least. Line up and the pitch. There's a strike, 1-1. That one just low. 2-1 as Reynolds steps back in, having a nice season at the plate. And this is hit in the air, foul. Heads! That was pretty close to some of the track team down there. It looks like the middle school track team in action just behind us. As Reynolds, who was at a 426 coming into this game, will hit this one foul up the left side. 426 batting average, 10 runs scored, 15 RBIs, and a home run to the junior's credit. McAvoy set to deal. And this is a high fly ball towards shallow left field. The shortstop ranging over and will make the catch. One away. As Andrew Brooks makes that catch. Vaccari remains at second base. Drew Simi to the plate. Wide up and the pitch. Swinging strike, and that almost got away. But it was foul ball. From the stretch. That one just high. Runner back to second as McAvoy stepped off the mound briefly. McAvoy deals, swinging strike. 1-2. Lineup and the pitch. And this is on the ground. Took a hop on the infield grass glove by the shortstop. Throw to first, not a problem. A 6-3 ground out for Simi. Two away. Jake LeBlanc to the plate. Jake LeBlanc got a .400 batting average this season, has played in 13 games. Overall, he is 14-35 at the plate. McAvoy delivers, that one upstairs. 1-0. Deals, fouled away. 1-1. The leg lift and the pitch. There's a strike. One and two. Strike three. And that will do it for the bottom of the fifth. The Hillers leading Millis 3-1 as we head to the top of the sixth inning. Top half of the sixth inning as Millis will come to the plate. A new center fielder for the Hillers, Nate Wilson, into the game for Connor Hebert. And Hebert did slip earlier on the wet surface out there trying to make a play, so hopefully he's okay as John Manning will step in the catcher. Manning over two as Jeff Haller set to deal. As this is hit foul, 0-1. Haller delivers, and this is on the ground, a little chip shot, and that is going to bounce off the glove of Vaccari. That took an awkward bounce right into his glove, and you could argue if that was a single or an error. I'll give it an error because they gave the hitter a single on the last one, so. But we'll get the official ruling after the game. As Bryce Latosik steps in, the second baseman, and takes strike one. So one on and no outs for Millis here in the top of the sixth. And the cloud's starting to get a little bit more ominous again as there's a strike, 0-2. Haller set to deal. Swinging strike. One away. Coming up to the plate now is Jared Pittman, the left fielder. There's a strike. 0-1. Runner leading off of first. That's fouled away, 0-2. That was over by us. Haller delivers. Strike three, two away. Two straight strikeouts for Haller. So far in this game, he has six strikeouts as Tim Horahan will come to the plate. Ball Excuse me, as that one's fouled away. A correction on the strikeouts. It's actually 8. We had a pass ball strikeout earlier in the game, as there's a strike there. 0-2. Chance to strike out the side here is Tim Horahan down 0-2. Runner on first, 2 outs. That pitch just low, 1-2. Set to deliver. Strike 3, and Jeff Haller strikes out the side. It is 3-1 Illers as we head to the bottom of the 6th. Bottom of the 6th inning, a 3-1 lead for the Illers. As coming to the plate now will be Sam Lehman, the left fielder. 0-2 in this game, reached on an error and scored a run. As this is hit up the middle to the shortstop, throw to first is in time. A 6-3 ground out. And that'll bring up Jeff Haller. Well, it's been a pretty good pitcher's duel here between Pat McAvoy and Jeff Haller, as McAvoy deals a breaking pitch and therefore a strike. 0-1. Wind up and the pitch. That is going to be strike 2, or excuse me, ball 1. He was able to check his swing. McAvoy deals. And this is hit into center field and will be caught for the second out of the inning. Chris Edwards was there. That'll bring up Connor Hebert. Wind up and the pitch. There's a strike. There's ball 1. 1-1. McAvoy with the leg lift and the pitch. Breaking pitch up high, 2-1. Swinging strike, 2-2. Leg lift and the pitch. There's strike 3. A 1-2-3 inning for the Hopkinton Illers offense. And we will head to the top of the 7th. Millis down to their final 3 outs, trailing 3-1. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Weston Nurseries, located at 93 East Main Street. You can find them online at westonnurseries.com. Top half of the 7th inning is the rain starting a little bit again. Big rain expected to move in, but the Illers just 3 outs away from getting the victory. As there's strike 1. At the plate. Right now is a pinch hitter, as that is crushed foul. And that came near a couple of fans near us. 0-2. Wind up and the pitch. That's foul. Right now the hitter is Ian Eldridge. As there, strike three, and excuse me, that was Alex Olmstead, the hitter, who just struck out. So one away. And that'll bring up Andrew Brooks. As the lefty steps in. Wide up and the pitch. There's ball one, 1-0. Wind up and the pitch. Fouled away, 1-1. Set to deal. Just low. 2-1. And that is inside, 3-1. Wide up in the pitch, upstairs. Brooks draws the walk, and that'll bring up Jake McKee, the third baseman. And we're gonna have a pinch hitter. As Haller set to deal. That one upstairs. Oh, it's Ryan Smith back into the game as that one's fouled away. 1-1. Ryan Smith was the starting third baseman. And he came back into the game. Max Morin due up on deck. 1-1, one out, one on. Ball two, runner takes off from first. Third stolen base of the game for Andrew Brooks. Leg lift and the pitch. This is hit in the air, foul. 2-2. Runner leading at second. And this is a slicer in a right field. That'll drop down. Runner will be held up at third. So a single. And that ball was thrown out of play. So Brooks will get the free path to home plate. And it's a 3-2 game. So another error there by the Hillers. A single for Ryan Smith, an RBI. Single, you can now credit it. And then he advances on the error to second base. Andrew Brooks comes around to score, and Max Moore into the plate. So a 3-2 game, and now Coach Jay Golden out to talk to Haller. And rain, big rain quickly moving in. And we're going to have a new pitcher here for the Hopkinton Hillers. Coming in to pitch now is Tom Onsey, the senior. Onsey typically a starter for the Hillers, but he's going to come in and try to close this out, getting into the last few games of the season for Hopkinton. You got to get to that 10-win mark to get into the postseason. So these games, very important down the stretch. So relief pitcher by the Hillers, one out, a 3-2 score. The Hillers leading Millis. We'll take a timeout on HCAM. Tom Otsie into the game for the Hopkinton Hillers to try to close this one out. A 3-2 game after one run scores for Millis. Andrew Brooks came around due to an errant throw. And he got the free pass to home plate because of the errant throw and out of play. Wind up in the pitch. And this is hit in the air, a little pop up, and it's handled. Nice job by Reynolds, two away. Millis down to their last out. Billy Barrett to the plate. There's strike one. And this is hit in the air. It is in foul territory. And that'll make it 0-1. That was over by us. Wide up and the pitch. Fouled away, 0-2. Two outs, runner on second, and 0-2 count. To Billy Banks. Billy Barrett, excuse me. Tom Otsie in on relief, trying to earn the save here. That pitch up high, 3-2. Line up and the pitch. Just outside. Otsie set to deliver. There's strike three, and the Hopkinton Hillers get the 3-2 victory over Millis in what was fortunately a fast-moving game with some bad weather approaching. Jeff Holler gets the win, Tom Otsie gets the save, and the Hopkinton Hillers improved to 9-7 on the season, just one win away from a playoff berth. For Bob Hamilton on camera, I'm Tom Nappy. We thank you for watching Hopkinton Hillers baseball here on HCAM. Enjoy the rest of your day, everybody.